smile and say hi to Nydia.
Hello, good morning.
Get to be on TV.
Hey. Morning.
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 Good morning, everyone, and welcome to a special call meeting in connection with the water contract coming in Forsyth County. This time, I would like to ask everyone to stand and let's pledge the flag, please. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you very much. Yeah, welcome. See that we have a lot of distinguished guests here with us today. Recognize Commissioner Tam, Commissioner Boff, Commissioner Amos, and certainly all of you are distinguished guests. We're glad to have all of you here with us. This was a special call meeting as I, first of all, I hear motion to call meeting order.
Make a motion.
Second.
Second.
In discussion, please signify and raise your right hand. Let the record show that Councilman Ralph Perry is out. He is in the hospital and has had surgery, and we hope he's doing good and wish he and his family well. Again, as I was saying, this was a special call meeting for the consideration of the proposal that the county sent to the city May the 18th, reference to the city-county water contract. The difference is the one that was sent May the 7th and the one that was sent May the 18th. This is binding, and the May 7th was a binding contract. This contract has a certain, has five additional terms with it. And certainly non-binding proposal, this one here to me is actually worse than the other. There's five additional terms that was added. One of them was added in that the county has no legal obligation to pay the city the portion that they've been invoiced on the treatment, on the intake in Lake Manila. So my first request to the city that I would, to the council, I'd recommend that their proposal of May the 18th be rejected. Chair, I entertain a motion.
Make a motion.
A motion from Rupert, second from Lewis. Any discussion? Please vote, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Now, to counter that, certainly we are trying to accommodate the Board of Commissioners any way we can to accommodate the water contract and to move it forward. The city submitted a proposal May the 7th to the county, and of course it was rejected. The city has taken that proposal and tweaked it a little bit. Proposal is basically for treated water at 225,000 gallons. For a 5-year contract, and which we think is certainly a fair, more than fair deal. We have also given them on the raw water. I might also add that we tweaked the treated water. It had a 3-tier, 225 for the first 3,330,000 gallon a day. We put that on the monthly average at 225. The $2.40, the middle tier was taken out, and it's $3.50. Anything over the 3,330,000 gallon on a monthly average. So the middle tier is taken out of the non-binding, out of the city's contract, which was binding. The raw water pumping from Lake Lanier to the county's treatment plant. It basically stayed the same, and it's for a 10-year agreement. The county had requested at one time a 50 years, a 25 years, a 15 years. So this is a contract that we feel is the raw water is extremely fair. The way I would look at it, if the county had its own water treatment facility, it's a certain amount of labor involved, there's a certain amount of power cost involved, there's a certain amount of risk factor involved. All of these are calculated, depreciation involved, and all these are calculated to come up with the price of this water. There's been an interim study of 18 cities and counties surrounding Cumming and Forsyth County, and Cumming and Forsyth County's water rates are the cheapest of those 18 surrounding cities and counties. The average cost of those 18 cities and counties per 1,000 gallon is $5.39. Now the city is proposing $2.25 a 1,000 gallon. And that's a 5-year fixed rate. So the council has the proposal. County has made a lot of money off the city's water. There's been some suggestion that the city's cost of the water plus a fair profit is the way to go, and that's exactly what we're doing. The county buys the water from the city of Cumming for $2.25. Currently, they sell it for $4.79 a thousand gallon, the county is. That's on the minimum, and you take the high tier when you use over 36,000 gallons, it's $10 a thousand gallon. $10. So conceivably, the county's taking the city water and doubling the price of it, and maybe tripling the price of certain things. So we think the city's price is very fair, more than fair. In addition, the county made on buying water from the city last year, from the figures I've seen, looks like the county made $16 million. The city's budget's only $12 million. So who's making all the money? So we have a proposal here, and I might add that this proposal is coming at the end of a 25-year working relationship with the city and county on the contract that was entered into in 1987. And this 25-year expires this Saturday. And with this proposal, if the county has any intentions of trying to resolve this and want to sign off on this binding contract, and maybe it can be tweaked a little bit with the county's input in the next couple of days, but if they have any intention to tweaking the contract, I apologize. Attorney General, I don't know if we have a legal meeting. Anyway, if the county wants to work on this for the next couple of days, I'll be available Wednesday and Thursday. Friday's out of the picture. I'm busy all day, and of course, the contract expires on Saturday. So with that said, council has copies of the proposal that's been worked up, and the chair will entertain a motion if the county and the cities wants to submit this binding proposal to the county. And by the way, this can be submitted later on today to the county for their consideration. I understand they have a meeting this afternoon.
I make a motion to approve the contract.
I have a motion from Rupert, second from Lewis, to send the contract to the county as it's been presented. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Now, what I'd like to ask the council, in view of the fact that I will not call another special meeting tomorrow or Wednesday or Thursday, which contract is set to expire. Does the council
I have a motion to that
see effect that they want to authorize me to negotiate with the county and sign off if they
I say that. I make a motion that if there's any small tweaking to the what we're sending them, we authorize you to make that and sign off on it. And that's my motion.
Have a motion from Lewis to have a second.
Second.
In discussion, please signify by raising your right hand. You now. Thank you very much. I hear a motion to adjourn.
Back motion.
Second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. You now. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Passion for you.
That's right, he opened that door.
Pardon? The crisis in the people is here. The courteous thing is in.
Sit down. I need to send a lead letter.
Sure. I was.
We need that to do that courtesy.
Sure. I will.
How you doing, sir? Thank you. Yeah, Godspeed, you guys will be something. Can I ask the city's infrastructure lies on leased land with the Borough Department?
Yes, sir.
What is the term of that lease?
They don't give you a specific. They just give you a permit to be there.
Your
allocation is based on needs.
Right, I understand that.
And your lease is based on that. So they don't give you.
It's not a 99-year lease
No. You don't go in there and spend $100 million over a period of years and then say, well, at the end of the lease, you got to move.
Quite frankly, a lot of places are built to suit and leased.
And you don't buy government land on the lake that's not for sale, so we can't deed anybody anything. That was
understand.
That was one of the things that the commissioner wanted, a deed for portion of the intake and everything, so we can't do that. We're not deeded anything.
They could theoretically share ownership of that infrastructure, the improvements upon that leased property.
How would that work?
It would work excellent, actually.
How would it work?
Well, one thing, the permission, didn't you have to get permission to build an intake of the capacity of 105 million gallons a day? Or did you just decide, well, you know, we're going to use 105 million gallons a day, it's rejected, so we're just going to build that? Didn't city have to submit a plan, drawing engineered, to either DNR or Army Corps of Engineers stating our intake, we're having a problem with their intake, we're sucking a bunch of dirty water, and we need to get that intake out there into the lake. And so we need to rebuild that intake. And then you proposed the capacity. They told you, okay, well, how was that construed?
Whenever the lake went down below the 1050 level, right, back 3 or 4 years ago, we lost ability to get the water into the cofferdam.
Right, right, yeah, you were drawing.
So we had to put portable pumps out into the lake to get the water into the cofferdam so we could pump it to the treatment plant.
Right.
So in virtue of the lake going down to the irrigation level, basically, we requested permit from the Corps to put air intake level down to the 1017.
Right, that.
Into the Chesapeake River, the deepest part of Lake Lanier.
Right, the portion that would remain.
And so we have the deepest intake in the lake now. And right, that was approved, but it wasn't approved for 50 years or 100 years or none of that. It was approved based on the need.
So that lease then is perpetual lease. It's an open end.
It's eternal.
It was described to me by Army Corps of Engineers Southern Legal Counsel Neil Purcell as being up for renewal, but he couldn't say when.
That's the allocation will be up after.
No, I specifically asked about the lease, the terms of the lease agreement, because I was trying to ascertain whether or not the county owned property, and because that was in conflict with the way
the Army Corps of Engineers. The city doesn't own it. Right. It's owned by the Corps.
Right. It's leased land, and we pay for the infrastructure.
We were permitted every step of the way by EPA, EPD,
right,
and the Corps of Engineers.
And the considerations for it to be built, constructed at 105 million gallons per day capacity.
Those plans were approved based on the build-out need of coming in Forsyth County, and that's what we turned in, even though we're not pumping, but 35 million gallon a day, what the permit, under the permit.
Right, it's 34 million gallons per day at 37 max peak, but you can never exceed that. It means the average 34 million gallons a day.
If there's a need, we can exceed it, but it's got to be a need.
Exactly. But overall, it's not supposed to be.
So the permit, the lease and the permit is not equated on the fact that you're only going to get a 50-year lease, and at the end of that, we're going to take your $100 million, $200 million project and not renew it.
Well, there you go, Mayor. That would be my concern as a citizen of Forsyth County, would be us to indenture our population demographics with the city of Cumming to justify the allocation of you to draw from that intake, whereas the Army Corps of Engineers right now states, from their perspective, that the permits were granted temporary in nature. Now, the permits that are to be re-granted come December or January of 2013, because of this reauthorization or they're redetermining their authority. They're going to determine how much water is in the lake to be distributed to the municipalities, how much that needs to go to the muscle.
That was discussed 10 years ago, right, and at that time, the discussion was based on the fact that each intake owner of each intake is going to buy acreage amount of water in Lake Lanier,
right,
and it's going to be predicated on a certain fee,
right,
and that fee was determined back 10 years ago to be around 2 cents, of 2 to 3 cents a thousand gallon. Based on that, that's what the county is paying for, mm-hmm, right now,
right,
and paying for less than 10 cents a thousand
gallon. The city's legal ability to be withdrawing water from the lake rides today on that live and let live clause.
Everybody's permit is, not just theirs, it's
everybody's. That's right, everybody's is holdover pending this reauthorization of the authority,
yeah,
and then they're gonna use some new methodology to validate the veracity of everybody's.
I understand the whole concept. I've been through it all. Through the,
well,
through
you're, the you are the chairman, of, you're a chairman on the board of the so, Municipal and Georgia
right,
Water
so,
Planning
so,
District.
Exactly right. So we feel that we're working more than fair with the county on these issues. If I was a county commissioner, I would have already settled this issue. We've been trying diligent for the last couple of years. I've been talking to the commissioners individually, and I would jump, because our study on that, and I thought I had that study here. Yeah.
You're talking about pricing structure?
This is the pricing structure by the engineers.
Right.
And our
That's the 18 municipalities?
18.
And the average price, I think, to note of it?
You see, the average price right here is $539.
Yeah.
And you see, I've got circled here for South County.
Right.
And the city of Cumming are the two cheapest of anybody in this.
And rightfully so, sir, because we are approximately to the lake.
And it's not reasonable to assume if the county takes the water and the county makes $16 million a year on profit, is it not reasonable to assume that the city has used the reserves, depleted the reserves to build this facility, that the county pays the city a profit and so we can put back in our reserve? I mean, that's the way things work.
Most businesses make their capital improvements are included in their pricing structure to begin with. You don't get a bill at the end of some term.
Yeah, it was included based on the predication that the county would pay 65% of the cost.
And therein lies some disagreement with that, because that was an emergency repair versus a maintenance.
Well, thank you very much. I think we could probably talk all day and not agree.
We could. Thank you very much.
Judson.
Thank you very much.
Judson. Mayor Ford Graver, this is Judson here. He wanted to meet you and say hello there.
Hello, Justin. Justin who?
Judson.
Justin who?
Meadows.
Oh, it's your son. Okay.
Judson Roberts Meadows. You know Judson Roberts over from...
I know Judge Roberts.
That's related. What do you think about his tie?
No.
See, and I was worried about wearing my colors today, and look at there. It worked out good.
Did you get that from Patrick also ties?
I don't know.
I wonder if that was a gift.
Good to see you there, about Forsyth.com. Possum News Channel was off the air today.
You know, the proximity of Forsyth County and Cumming to that lake should offer the citizens of all Forsyth County a good deal on water for our proximity to that lake. And that's exactly the considerations of Army Corps of Engineers and DPD when they granted an intake structure to be built at the capacity to serve all of Forsyth.